Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the syllabus of civil services examination, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So also friends, we have a mains answer writing series in which what we do, we daily give you a certain number of questions of which you have to write the answers. So the students were demanding that please upload the model answers of these questions as well. So what we have decided, to upload daily one model answer so that get an idea about how to approach the answer writing, because a lot of students face problem in answer writing and building up, we can say, beautiful answer, in writing a beautiful answer. So for that purpose we have started this initiative. So first of all, let me tell you that it will be difficult to cover all the 5 questions over the YouTube, so that's why we will provide you the answer of only one question so that you may get an idea that how to approach and how to deal with this answer writing thing. So basically, how to approach this question? So this question is, there is undergoing a massive expansion of social media platforms among people. What implications does it have for Indian society? So here the question is simple. We know all of you people and us know that there is a massive expansion in social media platforms. So here the question simply says you to highlight the implications that it could have on Indian society. So how can you approach this answer? So first of all, you have to focus upon the social media, that is the pace with which it is developing and the scale and the extent to which this expansion is taking place. And at the next step, you have to just focus upon the implications, that these implications or consequences may be either positive or these may be negative. So before starting the answer, let me tell you friends that a note, very important note, is that this is not a model answer as we have defining it earlier. So we are using this terminology because students have the habit to say a particular answer as model answer, but you are requested to take it as only reference source, because no answer in UPSC can be model answer. Every answer has its own positives and negatives. So had that been the case, the UPSC toppers would have scored 100% marks, but that is not the case. So that's why we can't say that a particular answer is model answer. Basically, answer must have certain essential components. So if those components you are mentioning in your answer, and if you are writing in a way that in which UPSC wants, then certainly you will fetch extra marks in your answer writing part of the exam, that is mains exam. So let's start our discussion. So friends, as you know that social media plays an integral role in our lives. So it has revolutionized the way the people communicate and socialize on the web. So internet is basically the medium, and these social media platforms are a kind of a platform through which there is a share of information, opinion and all of this. So there are a lot of social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, who have single-handedly kind of changed the society and altered the way we view ourselves and other people. So in fact, there was an internet trends report 2017, which is a two-year report. So 27% of India's population uses internet. So certainly this number would have increased by now, because daily a lot of lakhs of people are joining over internet. So this place highlights that the social media is playing a forefront the role it is playing in the forefront of online penetration. So everything has positive and negative implications, specifically technology also. So social media is a kind of information and communication technology revolution. So it has positive as well as negative impact. So simply we have to first focus upon the positive impacts. So what is the positive impact? So friends, as you know that there is a lot of injustice and inequality that is going on in our society. So many a times those who are from vulnerable section, they are not able to raise their voice. Why? Because the established and institutionalized modes of we can say platforms of their kind of voice raising are not that much inclusive, and they are denied that place in the public so that they can raise their grievances. So that thing is very difficult. So social media has revolutionized this because now voices that were previously excluded, for example, women, marginalized sections, and grieved citizens, they are now finding it as a new channel to fight injustice and inequality. So, for example, in case of women, the best example could be the Me Too campaign, in which there was a lot of kind of, we can say, participation by women. And in fact, for marginalized sections, you might have recently seen the case of a couple complaining about the threat to their life because they married with their own will. So then there are grieved citizens who raise their complaints about the government, about the, we can say, the interfaces at which they face the government. So these voices that were previously excluded from conversations can find a channel. So without social media, this could not have been possible, because also, for example, it also social media is becoming a platform on which various issues, people are becoming aware of various issues. For example, environmental issues. So you might have come across various types of kind of photographs or videos that are being shared over media by your non-persons that point to the high degree of environmental pollution that is going on. And then there are other social and ethical issues that are raised. For example, I have already highlighted Me Too. And then these increased visibility of these issues have kind of shifted the balance of power from the hands of a few to the masses. So a kind of democratization is happening. So it is a kind of activism on the part of the citizens because they participate in these debates. But the question remains as to whether this awareness is translating into real change. Because social media debates are often, we can say, heated, and sometimes people turn rigid in their views, and then cyberbullying starts, and this, we can say, targeting of the people who have a different opinion. So, and then there is the issue of creating awareness. So, awareness has been created, as this is a already stated point. Next is this social media certainly has made us closer to the other parts of the world. And also, with using this, we can stay in touch with friends and the families. So, it helps in creating public opinion, for example, Anna Hazare social media campaign against corruption. And then there is now going on the fight against the discrimination that is faced by LGBTQ community. So, recently, you might have seen that the 17th Lok Sabha elections, every major party was using this platform. So, certainly, that has demonstrated the role played by social media in today's India. And other thing is that this social media is increasingly adopted by politicians, political activists, social movements. So it is a kind of a platform through which citizens are engaged or organized, and the communication is kind of done between the citizens and the politicians. And thus also there is a kind of organization of movements over social media. And then comes here, it provides the opportunity for all writers and bloggers to connect with their clients and all those things that over social media. For example, YouTube is also a kind of a more or less social media platform. So I'm teaching you, for example, then certainly you are listening me, then this has revolutionized the way the education is spreading, the opinion is spreading, the information is spreading. Because had that not been the case, I might have you might have not heard me ever. So that is the case of positive outcome. So next also then comes the negative effects. So negative effects, the major negative effects are the issue of privacy issue, because there is a lot of kind of concern among people that that these companies, and this concern is not limited to people but to intelligentsia section also, that these companies are using personal data, and then there is cyber bullying taking place and online harassment is taking place. For example, people are bullied over cyber and online harassment of girl, and then character assassination and trolling. So because, for example, if a particular political party is targeting the candidate of other political party in a way, that character assassination may take place. So you might have got what I want to say. I will not name any party here. So that is the case, in fact, in 2019 elections as well. So monopolization of corporate world is taking place. For example, if there is now it is not much known that what they are recording exactly, but your behavior is continuously being recorded. So what you like, what you on what type of things you comment, how you comment, so what is your attitude, now the in fact the Facebook has included in its platform or its platform the emojis of that anger and feeling, and all those things are being recorded. So this is a fundamental business model of these platforms. So they try to collect as much personal information on individuals as possible. So they basically, the purpose of this information is to kind of profiling your behavior and profiling your preferences and your the things you hate and or for example you don't like. So basically this information is then used to sell highly customized, we can say targeted advertising to the companies. And also there is very little understanding of what exactly they are collecting, and there is little regulation and little known about what consequences it could have on the democracy or in the over the society in general. So this level of data collection also presents that that this will create to a kind of a monopolization of power, because if a company, particular company, has a lot of data, then it will certainly its economic power will grow. So it will create a customized advertisement campaigns, and certainly the small sections of society, the small entrepreneurs may not be able to compete with the high corporate individuals with high net wealth. So Cambridge Analytica scandal is another case and example. So also researchers have found that hyper networking has in fact lead to negative health behavior. For example, there is laziness among people, there is obesity problem, there is depression problem, drug abuse, and it can even lead to suicides, because for example blue whale suicides. So people are continuously seeing the other ones they are knowing, so they are seeing that they are successful. Somehow they feel that they are isolated from this world, and this problem is there. Then people get depressed, and this may even lead to suicide. And other thing is, India is a secular country, but there is an issue, and it is a multi-religious, multi-community country. So it is home to various religious and cultural beliefs. But this mere comment or opinion on a certain belief on social media spreads like fire, leading to riots and destructive rallies. For example, Muzaffarnagar riots. And then social media has also faced criticism due for lynching incidents, because fake information is being shared. So in fact, a study from Pew Research says that 62% of the people get their news from social media. So it is not the case that they read other sources or they rely only on Facebook or other social media platform, but you can see that they receive their news from social media. So any information that is being shared over it certainly makes influence over the society in general, because if that much number of people are sharing are getting news from the social media, certainly it will lead to building of opinions. So for that purpose, political campaigns have been increased tremendously over this social media. And also there is issue of spread of fake news, because people rely on social media, then there is very much threat of fake news, because the researchers are also saying that in fact this has not expanded the worldview of a particular person, but it has kind of led to the more rigidity in the opinions, because fake news are again and again shared, and you are shown deliberately a particular news because of your preferences that have been recorded earlier. So you are in a hurry to get like, share, comment, and all these things lead to major problems like fake news. These lynching incidents were due to this spread of fake news, and then riots and destructive rallies. All these things can have potential harm on the potential harm to the society. And then there is radicalization of youth. So it is it may be we can say IAS in fact launched propaganda over this Facebook, social media platforms, and then there is there are other issues, not of only of IAS, then there is radicalization of other religions also that is taking place. So various initiatives have been taken by social media platforms to control these. For example, a campaign by social media platforms like WhatsApp that started a nationwide campaign called Share Joy Not Rumors, and then Facebook launched the Social for Good campaign to address the issues such as cyberbullying, mental well being. So all of these things is that the conclusion is only that digitization era is reality and we cannot ignore it and we cannot run from it. So the necessity in this case is that we promote media literacy, because the people must have an idea that how to authenticate the reality of a particular news. The government should in fact bring robust data privacy norms, so that a policy framework must be there to tackle the data leaks. And then in nutshell, social media is of significant importance, and it has both pros and cons. So it depends upon how we use it, how judicially and effectively we make it make the use of this these social media platforms for our benefit. So in the end, there is a quote by a person, Eric Kuhlman. He has said that we don't have a choice whether we do social media or not. The question is how well we do it. So today, this is not the question. You have to do social media, but the question is how well we do it, or how judicially and effectively we do it. So this is all about today's questions. Today's question, if you like the question, if you like the way that question has been framed, then do ensure that you like our video. And basically, the purpose here was to analyze the implications. So also friends, as I've told you, we have daily mains answer writing practice series. So if you are interested to join that series, then you can mail us at this email ID achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number 8968920720. So in that series, we properly evaluate your answers, we provide you feedback, and we share with you all the reference sources, or you can say it model answers of all the questions. And not just one question. So over YouTube we discuss only one question, but in case you are interested to join, you will be provided all the reference sources provided you join our test series. So thank you friends, have a very nice day. Do ensure that you like and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, have a very nice day ahead.